Students, in this video, you are going to take information about electrochemistry. 1 mark question one, 2 marks question also one, and 5 marks question also one. Total 8 marks you will score in final board examination very soon. Very easy to prepare. Yes, the first question is reactions occur in Daniell cell at anode. What is anode? Zinc rod dipped in zinc sulfate solution of 1 molar concentration is anode. That is start melting. So zinc solid is melted into zinc 2 plus ions and electrons are released. These electrons are travel through external wire and reach cathode. Yes, what is cathode? Copper rod at. Copper rod dipped in copper sulfate solution is cathode. There, copper 2 plus ions take these 2 electrons which are in aqueous solution state and convert it into copper solid deposited on the cathode. So this is one. Sometimes what is asked? What is overall reaction asked for 1 mark? Overall reaction in Daniell cell is asked, and that is for 1 mark question. How do you answer? Yes, by combining these two, you will have a final one, that is zinc 2 plus aqueous plus copper solid. Both are combined to give copper 2 plus. Right, it is a mistake has happened. Zinc solid, copper 2 plus aqueous give copper solid and zinc 2 plus aqueous. This carries 1 mark. We have to practice. Yes, what is the overall reaction? Zinc solid combined with copper 2 plus aqueous to give copper solid and zinc 2 plus aqueous. This carries 1 mark. Practice well. Write the Nernst equation for Daniell cell. Write the Nernst equation for Daniell cell. This carries 1 mark in the examination. Yes, what is that one? New potential of the cell is equal to standard potential of the cell minus 0.0591 divided by n number of electrons, that is 2 here, n number of electrons. How? Observe here, copper 2 plus 2 copper, 2 electrons, or zinc is converted to zinc 2 plus 2 electrons. The same information is also available here. So from this knowledge, you can easily write here n value 2 log the product is Zn 2 plus, so that you have to write Zn 2 plus concentration square brackets divided by copper 2 plus. Yes, why? Because yes, copper solid and zinc solid both are not taken into consideration. Their active masses are 1. That is answer. So your answer is like this. So prepare in a particular manner. Yes, let us have a 3 mark question from this one. E naught cell of the reaction is given, that is 3.17 volts. E cell is asked to calculate, and cell reaction is given. Magnesium solid react with 2Ag plus 0.001 molar. Gives Mg2 plus aqueous ion with 0.130 moles per liter and 2 moles of silver in solid state. Yes, how do we answer this one? Formula 1 mark. Formula 1 mark. Yes, so that is new potential of the cell is equal to standard potential of the cell minus 0.0591 by n number of electrons log product is magnesium 2 plus concentration divided by reactant ion, that is Ag plus. Here 2 moles is to be provided here. This is 1 mark. Substitution simplification 1 mark. Answer with units 1 mark. Yes, E naught cell already given here, that is 3.17 minus 0.0591 by here how many moles of electrons? Magnesium 2, magnesium 2 plus 2 electrons, or 2Ag plus 2Ag is 2 electrons. 2 we have to write. Log magnesium 2 plus concentration 0.13 divided by this is 0.001 square. Then it becomes 3.17 minus 0.0, 2 2s are 4, 2 4s are 8, 2 5s are 10, 2 5s are 10, log 0.13 into this is 10 to the power minus 3 square, 10 to the power minus 6, minus 6 becomes 10 to the power 6. This becomes, yes, after simplification, answer is. Yes, now the answer is 2.96 after taking the logarithm and all these things. Yes, this carries 1 mark, this carries 1 mark, and this is 1 mark. This you have to score in this manner. Yes, observe, calculate Gibbs energy change of the reaction at 298 Kelvin, that is room temperature, for the following reaction. 3 moles of magnesium solid react with 2 moles of aluminum 3 plus aqueous ion gives 2 moles of aluminum solid and 3 moles of magnesium 2 plus aqueous. So standard potential of the electrode potential of magnesium is minus 2.36. Standard reduction potential of aluminum is minus 1.66. Yes, what you have to calculate? We have to calculate delta or Z naught. Before that, we are calculating E naught cell is equal to E naught cathode minus E naught anode. This is required. Yes, what is cathode? Cathode is more potential. Cathode is more potential. More potential cathode. This is mathematically less potential. Less potential anode. So, cathode minus anode. Cathode is minus 1.66 minus of minus 2.37. Then you got the value minus 1.66 minus of minus plus 2.37, 7 minus 6, 1, 13 minus 6, 7, 0.71 volts. Right? Yes. Next step is, this is first part over, second part, delta R J naught is to be calculated. Yes. Take down that one. That is delta R J naught is equal to minus NFE naught cell. So E naught cell is here obtained. N value is decided with your intelligence, that is 2 into 3 plus 6 positive units of positive charge, or 3 into plus 2 6 units of positive charge. So this is an indication, minus 6 into 96,487, which is provided in the formula in the problem, and E naught cell is 0.71. so after simplification the answer is, yes, the answer is 414034.62 joules is the answer to score complete marks. Here observe, minus 2.36 wrong substitution, and it is 7.0, and it is 7.0, and the answer is 405 joules. This we have to observe. Why? Because here wrong substitution, 2.36, here 2.37 is substituted by me, and now correctly substituted, it is 0.70, it is 0.70, now the answer is this one. Just recorrect it. Yes, observe one more model from this subtopic. Calculate the equilibrium constant for the reaction copper plus 2 moles of Ag plus give rise 2 moles of Ag and copper 2 plus aqueous ions. Yes, E naught cell is given. What is the relation between E naught cell and equilibrium constant? E naught cell is equal to 0.0591 by n number of electrons log equilibrium constant. Yes. Now calculate log equilibrium constant is equal to, these two are multiplied, n into E naught cell divided by 0.0591. Substitute, how many electrons here involved? Ag2 plus, 2 moles of Ag plus is nothing but 2 moles of positive charge or 2 moles of positive charge. So n value to E naught cell E naught cell 0.46 divided by 0.0591. Yes, after simplification, the answer is 15.6. Yes, this is characteristic. This is mantissa. For mantissa, anti-logarithm is calculated. So, k equilibrium is equal to anti-log of 0.6 into mantissa directly taken into 10 to the power 15. Then, after getting this one, answer 3.92 into 10 to the power 15. If we want units, volts. Yes, draw a neat labeled diagram of standard hydrogen electrode is the information. Yes, first take a tank container. Yes, the container contains one molar H plus ion solutions aqueous, correct? Then what is introduced? A glass tube is introduced. Correct. And what is introduced? Platinum wire. Yes. This is platinum wire. And from this one, what is bubbled? H2 gas is bubbled at 1 bar pressure. And this is platinum. This carries 1 mark. Then what will be asked? Standard electrode potential, how much? Electrode potential of standard hydrogen electrode. So what is your answer? 0.00 volts. Yes, cell reaction is asked. Electrode reaction. What is electrode reaction in standard hydrogen electrode? This is 1 mark. This is 2 marks. Yes, answer is H plus aqueous take 1 electron give rise half H2 gas. Next, last one is represent the electrode. Represent SHE electrode. Yes, this is 1 mark. How do you answer this one? Platinum solid is supported with H2 gas, is with H plus ion aqueous. Okay, I hope you followed, and this is a frequently asking area. Prepare well. Yes, let us define two terms, that is under conductance, molar conductivity and limiting molar conductivity terms. We have to take that one. Yes, molar conductivity. Molar conductivity lambda m is equal to k a by l. Yes. How do you define this one? We are defining in this manner. The conductance of the conductance, this is the conductance of V volume of solution A is taken as V volume of area of cross section, V volume of solution, V volume of solution containing 1 mole of electrolyte, 1 mole of electrolyte kept between 2 electrodes separated by 2 electrodes of area of cross section A and distance of unit length. Distance of unit length. Yes, this is. Yes, therefore, the formula is molar conductivity is equal to molar conductivity is equal to K into V. Because area of cross section is V volume and 1 is the length between two electrodes is 1 unit length, then that is KV. Yes, or lambda m is equal to K by C expressed in moles per meter cube. This is another formula separately asked. Give an expression. Give an expression. Yes. Give an expression between lambda m and concentration of electrolyte in moles per meter cube. Then this is the answer, and K is expressed in Siemens per meter. This we have to follow. Clear? Yes, how do we define limiting molar conductivity? Yes, very simple. Molar conductivity. Molar conductivity of an electrolyte. Of an electrolyte at concentration 0 or at infinity dilution. Yes, based on this one we rush into another term. Yes, this is a frequently asking question. Define Kohlrush law simply, or Kohlrush law for independent migration of ions. As my ions are migrating, they are not influencing the conductivities. That's why it is independent of migration of ions. And what is the application of Kohlrush law? These two are separately or commonly asked for 2 marks or 2+1, 3 marks. Yes, take that information. That is this limiting molar conductivity of an electrolyte. The limiting molar conductivity. Molar conductivity of an electrolyte. Yes, on a fan electrolyte is the sum of the individual contribution of the individual contribution of anion and cation of the electrolyte. Anion and cation of the electrolyte. Yes, how is the mathematical formula? Lambda naught of electrolyte is equal to lambda naught of cation plus lambda naught of anion. Yes, how do we answer this one? This is lambda naught of NaCl is equal to lambda naught of Na plus lambda naught of Cl minus. Some people are interested plus here plus missed like that. Very simple. This is sum of the individual contribution of the ions. First one. Second one, MgCl2. Lambda naught of MgCl2. Limiting molar conductivity of magnesium chloride is equal to limiting molar conductivity of magnesium 2 plus ion into limiting molar conductivity of Cl minus ion, generally written by the student, but these 2 moles is to be included. Then only your answer will be correct. So lambda naught of aluminium sulfate formula is needed. Some students are not familiar with our formula. Al2SO4 taken thrice, aluminium 2. So that is Al2SO4 taken thrice, aluminium 2 moles into lambda naught of Al3 plus 3 moles of lambda naught of SO4 2 minus is your answer. The last one, applications. Application of Kohl-Rush law. Yes. How do you write application of Kohl-Rush law? Yes, one is, it is used to calculate. Used to calculate limiting molar conductivity of weak electrolyte. Like weak electrolyte. What is the example you studied? That is example acetic acid, ammonium hydroxide, etc. Next one, degree of dissociation is calculated. Degree of dissociation, that is alpha, calculated. How is it calculated? Degree of dissociation alpha is calculated. How is it calculated? Yes, the formula is, observe the formula, alpha is equal to lambda C by lambda naught, limiting molar conductivity C concentration by limiting molar conductivity of S. And what is also calculated? S K is calculated. You write any one of the points as application of Kohl-Rush law. Continue the discussions under this point. Calculate lambda M naught, that is limiting molar conductivity for magnesium chloride. This is a question. The limiting molar conductivities of magnesium 2 plus ion and Cl minus ions are, this is magnesium 2 plus and this is Cl minus ion respectively. Then what is the formula? A solution. That is lambda naught MgCl2 is equal to lambda naught of Mg2 plus 2 into lambda naught of Cl minus. You score 1 mark in this case. Yes, substitute lambda M magnesium 106 plus 2 into 76.3. After simplification, the answer is, yes, the answer is 258.6 Siemens centimeter square per mole. Yes, one more mark here, one mark. This is a 2 marks question, prepare well. See another simple question, that is draw a graph lambda M molar conductivity versus concentration, square root of concentration of a weak electrolyte acetic acid. Yes, what you have to take, this is a molar conductivity, zero concentration, square root of concentration on x-axis, molar conductivity on y-axis, S. As concentration zero approaches to zero, suddenly the conductivity is increased, molar conductivity. This is for weak electrolyte or acetic acid or weak electrolyte. If it is for strong electrolyte, how is the answer? Yes, for strong electrolyte, question is changed. Then how do you write this? You have to write in this manner, lambda M versus square root of concentration. This is the graph. Prepare in this manner. Observe another one. Limiting molar conductivity for sodium chloride, hydrochloric acid and sodium acetate are respectively this one. This is for NaCl, this is for HCl and this is for sodium acetate. Sodium acetate. Then limiting molar conductivity of acetic acid is given as per Kohl-Rush law. As what is your answer? As solution for Kohl-Rush law. Lambda naught M for CH3 COOH is equal to lambda naught of CH3 COO ion available in CH3 COO Na plus H plus ion available in HCl, and we have to remove Na and Cl, so that is minus limiting molar conductivity of NaCl. This is correct one, carries 1 mark. Yes, next one is substitution. 91 plus 11 not HCl is 425.9 minus 126.4. 390.5 Siemens centimeter square per mole. Yes, this is 1 mark and this is 1 mark. It is a 2 marks question expected in the examination. Observe this question. What happens to molar conductivity, when 1 mole of KCl is dissolved in 1 liter and diluted to 5 liters. So concentration is decreased. Nothing but that is molarity decreased. So what is the relation? Molar conductivity is equal to K into 1000 by molarity. Molarity is decreased. Molar. So answer is, simple answer is molar conductivity is increased. Another question will be asked, that is, sometimes what happens to K? What is K? K is conductivity. Yes, this is only asked in the examination, and you can write answer in this manner. Score 1 mark. Okay, so K, as molarity decrease, K is also decreased. So answer, conductivity decreased. Why conductivity is decreased? Why is conductivity decreased? So conductivity decrease means per unit volume the number of ions decreased. Here the ions are free to move. Why the it is increased means ions free to move. Why? Because dilution, more space is there among the ions. Here per unit volume number of ions decreased, that's why K is decreased if this question is asked. Observe this one. Any two factors which affects the conductivity of electrolyte. Yes, conductivity of electrolyte, that is nature of electrolyte is one. Yes, nature of electrolyte, strong electrolyte or weak electrolyte. Then concentration of electrolyte, more concentration, more ions. Concentration of electrolyte. Third one, size of the ion. Larger ion, smaller ion, migrates larger ion, very larger. So migration is difficult. Next, fourth one is viscosity of solvent. Okay, this you have to maintain. Any two you have to write. Any two from this one. Size of the ion, already studied in previous classes. No problem at all. Yes, observe. Why does the conductivity of solution decrease with the dilution? Already I discussed in the previous case. Yes, lambda m is equal to K into V. Yes, dilution increase means decrease dilution means decrease with the dilution means volume is increased. Dilution means volume is increased. As volume increased, product, this is inversely proportional, these two are. As answer is number of ions per unit volume is decreased. That's why K decrease with the dilution. Clear? Yes, this is increased directly proportional. Ions are free to move. This already discussed. Yes, it is our responsibility to know about units of resistance, as some Opposition in the flow of current is offered by the substance. That opposition is known as resistance. This is expressed in ohms, very well known by you. And specific resistance is ohm per meter. Conductivity is equal to, yes, conductance is ohm inverse. Ohm inverse is nothing but Siemens, yes. Specific conductance is ohm meter. This is ohm meter. Why? Because R is equal to rho is equal to RL by A. Yes, R is equal to rho L by A. Yes, ohm meter. This is ohm meter. Yes, this is, yes, this is Siemens per meter, and conductivity is Siemens per meter square per mole or centimeter square per mole, and it is meter inverse or centimeter inverse. Yes, this is the last one to close this electrochemistry successfully. As half an hour is sufficient to close your preparation to score somehow marks. Name the gas produced during the electrolysis of aqueous NaCl, that is 10% NaCl solution. Aqueous NaCl solution is called brine solution. As that is taken, and what is the reaction? Yes, answer is first reactions, then answer. Yes, what are reactions? 2Cl minus give rise Cl2 plus 2 electrons taking place at anode, and H2O. H2O, 2H2O take 2 electrons give rise H2 plus 2OH minus ion at cathode. So now come to the answer. Answer, yes, what is asked? Name the gas produced during electrolysis. Gas produced at cathode, at anode or cathode. Yes, at anode what is produced? Cl2. At cathode asked H2. This is answer you have to prepare. If you want equations, you just practice this one. All the best.